truth.
Saying that...
Would you like to tell the truth?
They should not be attending this meeting.
No, would you like to tell the truth?
This is a peaceful picket.
Yes, I'm being peaceful.
And we have a right to come here, and give information...
I'm not being aggressive.
...about what is really happening.
Yes.
This is a conference today about the alienated parents being called by families need fathers.
Please,
and we are mothers who have come to give the evidence about what is happening to mothers and children in the family courts. Unfortunately, in the enormous amounts of domestic violence that go on,
children are killed by their mothers. They are, that's true. Look at the government statistics.
This is the same problem in France, and mothers, children killed.
Yes.
I am a headmaster, and I in my school, in my school, a baby is killed by the father.
Yes,
and what's happening is the courts, family courts, are absolutely biased in favour of these fathers. The sexism in society is absolutely wild, and of course that is in the family courts. And these organisations, the National Society for Prevention of Cruelty to Children, should not be coming to a conference of families need fathers who are absolutely biased against mothers and try and say that it is mothers who cause more domestic violence than fathers. That is absolutely outrageous. We will give you some figures. 1 in 5 women between 16 and 59 have suffered sexual violence in England and Wales. 2 women a week are murdered by their partners. Not 2 men partners murdered by their women partners a week. 81% of victims of domestic violence are women. And these families need fathers deny this. And when CAFCASS, the Children's Court Service, that is supposed to be neutral and professional, that we all have to depend on, we mothers, have to depend on when we go to try and sort out family disputes. They are coming to this conference today of Families Need Fathers. And it's an outrage. And we have written to them this open letter, which we're giving out, and we're saying, do not go to this conference.
Families Need Fathers have a long track record since the 90s for denying domestic violence. What's happening at the moment is that women, mothers and children are at risk when we go to the family courts, because judges, with the complicity of organisations like CAFCASS, with the complicity of social services, are only too happy to give violent fathers unsupervised contact and even residence of their children. Sometimes the fathers have criminal records for rape and domestic violence. And yet, when it comes to the family court, judges are only too happy to dismiss it all as false allegations or give the father a second chance. Just like Weinstein is demanding at the moment in Hollywood that he should be given a second chance after he's had thousands and thousands of chances. He's demanded that people should be sympathetic to his right to rape and sexually harass any woman he likes because he's a powerful man. We are campaigning legal action for women, women against rape, and a number of other organizations. We are campaigning for the family courts to be open, just like the criminal courts are. Yes. The standards that are allowed in the family courts are much lower than what's going on in the criminal courts. Women are being cross-examined by their rapists and their attackers, and although the government has had to intervene and has changed the law a little bit, it's not nearly enough.
So nowhere to go. There's no housing, there's no benefits, there's benefit sanctions, and so women, mothers, are in the situation where they cannot feed their kids And this is being called neglect. Well, it's government neglect. They are the people who've introduced these austerity policies, and they continue to introduce them, as you will have heard, through the introduction of things like universal credit, where people are having to live 6 weeks without any income whatsoever. And people are being evicted all over this country because they cannot pay their rent. This is the situation we are in. And this is why we are so furious with the family court system, which behaves like, oh, we're just being fair to both sides. You're not being fair to both sides. Thank you.
From a men organization called Payday, we're here to support legal action for women and women against rape in opposing family needs fathers' agenda of supporting men who've been violent. Can I just say a couple of obvious things? We all have a mother, and if we are honest, we know from the bottom of our heart that the mothers, our mother, have done most, if not all, of the work. You know, there are a lot of men who have been raised by single mother, so all that work, years and years of caring work, is the work of women. It has to be the starting point when there are any discussion about who should look after the children. It can't be that the father who's been away, absent for years, you know, has the same right as the mother. It has to be based on the work that is being done, and we know that women are doing most of that work. My partner is also a child with another man, and I've seen in my own eyes how she did everything she could to keep in touch, to make sure that the father would be in touch with the child. In spite of the fact that the father was lousy, that he never kept to his promises, that he, at some time he was violent or semi-violent and dismissive of all the work that the mother was doing. Despite all of that, she made effort after effort to try to keep that contact. And the father never supported the child, neither emotionally, financially, or otherwise. So we have to acknowledge that as well. So, this is why we are here. We're supporting men who are accepting and acknowledging women's caring work, because this is the basis of the relationship. Thank you.